Yuba and Sutter community. Today, I wanted to talk to you about youth and the relationship regarding youth and COVID-19. So there's a lot of talk about evidence. Are kids more susceptible to COVID-19? Are they less susceptible to COVID-19? What does the current evidence show? So the current evidence show that in other countries who have resumed schooling, what happened? So in Israel, there was a big outbreak in a high school when they resumed a little bit too soon. In Denmark, when they did a phase-in gradual approach of resuming schooling for elementary school kids only, it went much better and there was no noted outbreak within their school. So with that said, I want to talk to you about, so what is the age cutoff? You know, I'm pretty sure you all have heard. Is it 10? Is it 11? Is it 12? So the most recent study coming out of South Korea is that they noted, after following several thousand cases in their close contact, that up until age 10, young children tend not to transmit COVID-19 among themselves or to adults. But starting at age 10, the transmission potential is the same as adults. So it's just one study, but it's a big study, and that is where the current evidence lies in regards to transmission potential and the breakdown among ages. Then you're gonna wonder, why is that? So there's one theory, and I'm gonna try to do some whiteboard drawing to kind of show it to you, all right? So when you are a small child, sorry for my stick figure, you really only have a few of these receptors. They're called ACE2 receptors, all right? So you maybe have two. Maybe by the time that you're 5, you get 3. And then it just goes on and on and on. And the theory is that by the time you're an adult, or maybe by the time you're 10 or 12, you have the full 100% of your ACE2 receptors, all right? And why does this even matter? We think that the coronavirus docks here in the body, meaning that the virus, once you breathe it in, it actually has to land on these receptors in order to enter your body, all right? So if a child, especially a young child, less than age 10, have less of these receptors, there's less likelihood that the virus can enter their body versus an adult who has way more of the receptors, more virus can enter the adult body, all right? So this comes to show young people, teenagers, you are not invincible. You have enough of the ACE receptor, ACE2 receptors, that the virus can enter your body and then multiply and multiply to the point where you will get infected. And when you get infected, you can have lots and lots of potential symptoms, not just respiratory symptoms, not just lung problems. It could be stroke, it could be heart attack, it could be a blue toe. And we can talk about some of those manifestations on next week's video. Thank you. Have a good night.